is Victor Benton. Nice to meet you. I'm one of the teachers here. I hope I didn't keep you waiting for too long. No? Okay. That's good. I had a little bit of a delay getting here. There was yet another rad roach infestation down at the diner. I think that makes like the fifth one this week. I don't know what's going on. If I were you, stick to canned rations for the next week or so. Or if you're gonna eat down at the diner, maybe stay away from the pancakes. So, how do you like life here in the vault? Yeah. Okay. What do you think of the overseer? Oh no, this is off the record. Just between you and me. Casual conversation. Same way. You know, somewhat stern, fairly lenient certain ways, runs a tight ship, I guess you could say. Well, what's that? You're itching for something to do. Well, that's pretty much the reason that you're here. You see, some other teachers, the faculty, and I were reviewing all of the vault dwellers' personnel files, and we noticed quite a few of them, including yourself, have not taken the generalized occupational aptitude test, or what we call the GOAT. And this is a very simple test of only 10 questions, but quite a rigorous test, quite demanding, and it helps us. Said it's only 10 questions. It shouldn't take too long. And then at the very end, I will review your answers, and we'll find, hopefully, we'll find a job that you're, that will make a good fit for you. That sound good? Okay. I hope you don't mind the lack of lighting or the ambiance of this room. I prefer to conduct these tests on a one-on-one personal basis. I feel that it creates a very relaxed, stress-free environment. Mindset for the person taking the GOAT. Some nice subdued lighting help you relax, help your mind relax. You don't have anyone else to worry about. There's no pressure. No, it limits and decreases the anxiety and stress. Okay. All right. So before we started with something to drink that I thought might give your mind a little pep, and mine too. I have two bottles of, I'm sure, your favorite. I know it's mine. Nuka-Cola. Yeah, I'm not really sure what happened to the labels. Must be the rad roaches. Probably trying to, you know, get into our stores and supplies. Now and then, some good days, some bad days, okay? Huh. Well, you know we have a vault doctor. I'm sure you could arrange for a checkup. And they could give you, you know, checkup, an exam, you know, and see if there's anything that might be bothering you. I hope you don't mind if I do this. I picked this up from one of the other vault dwellers. Experimental relaxation techniques. Doesn't really have a name, but he uses a lot of different objects, taps on them, scratches them, you name it. It's all kinds of different things, and it helps stress, ease, create some peace of mind. So, you might want to consider making an appointment with him as well. Okay, enough banter. Let me get these bottles opened. Another sound that you might like. And I'm just doing this to help you relax. this might sound a little weird, but there are certain sounds, certain situations, I get this really nice feeling in my scalp, my shoulders. It's like a cascade of electricity, almost like goosebumps or the shivers, but not uncomfortable. This is more of a pleasant feeling. So I'm not sure if you've ever experienced that. But you should make an appointment with that gentleman. Nothing quite like nice ice cold glass of Nuka-Cola. That's for you. Said this is just a little something I picked up. Might help your, get your mind calm so you're not stressed out about having to take a test. Sound. Nothing like the sound of a brand new bottle of Nuka-Cola being poured into a glass, huh? Yeah, I should have done that with yours. Sorry about that. Next time. wrists this way. It's why they call me the goat whisperer. So I'm just going to read each question to you and the possible answers to each question. Okay, are you ready? Okay, great. Question number one. You are approached by a frenzied vault scientist who yells, "I'm going to put my quantum harmonizer in your photonic resonation chamber." What is your response? And the possible responses are, one, "But doctor, wouldn't that cause a parabolic destabilization of the fission singularity?" 2. "Yeah, up yours too, buddy." 3. "Say nothing. Grab a nearby pipe and hit the scientist in the head to knock him out." For all you knew, he was planning to blow up the vault. 4. "Say nothing, but slip away before the scientist can continue his rant." What is your answer? 1, 2, 3, or 4? Okay. As an intern in the clinic, a patient with a strange infection on his foot stumbles through the door. The infection is spreading at an alarming rate, but the doctor has stepped out for a while. What do you do? 1. Amputate the foot before the infection spreads. Scream for help. 3. Medicate the infected area to the best of your abilities. 4. Restrain the patient and merely observe as the infection spreads. What is your answer? Confiscate the property by force and leave him there as punishment. 3. Pick the boy's pocket to take the stolen property for yourself and leave the boy to his fate. 4. Lead the boy to safety, then turn him over to the overseer. What is your answer? Okay. you to tea, but you are surprised when she gives you a pistol and orders you to kill another vault resident. What do you do? 1. Obey your elder and kill the vault resident with the pistol. 2. Offer your most prized possession for the resident's life. 3. Ask Granny for a minigun instead. After all, you don't want to miss. Or 4. Throw your tea in Granny's face. What will your answer be? Okay. Question 7. Oh no, you've been exposed to radiation, and a mutated hand has grown out of your stomach. What's the best course of treatment? 1. A bullet to the brain. 2. Large doses of anti-mutagen agent. 3. Prayer. Maybe God will spare you in exchange for a life of pious devotion. 4. Removal of the mutated tissue with a precision laser. What's your answer? Question 8. A fellow vault resident is in possession of a Grognak the Barbarian comic book, issue number 1. You want it. What is the best way to obtain it? 1. Trade the comic book for one of your own valuable possessions. 2. Steal the comic book at gunpoint. 3. Sneak into the resident's quarters and steal the comic book from his desk. 4. Slip some knockout drops into the resident's Nuka-Cola and take the comic book when he's unconscious. What will your answer be? 1, 2, 3, or 4? private room when no one is looking, and 1. Loosen some bolts on some pipes. When the sink is turned on, the room will flood. 2. Put a firecracker in the toilet. That's sure to cause some chaos. 3. Break into the locked medicine cabinet and replace his high blood pressure medication with sugar pills. 4. Manipulate the power wattage on his razor so he'll get an electric shock the next time he shaves. What's your answer? 1, 2, 3, or 4? Okay. Last question. Question 10. Probably one of the most difficult questions of the test. Who is indisputably the most important person in the vault? He who shelters us from the harshness of the atomic wasteland and to whom we owe everything we have, including our lives. 1. The overseer. 2. The overseer. 3. The overseer. Or 4. The overseer. What will your answer be? Sure, I can repeat the question and answer it again. Who is indisputably the most important person in the vault? He who shelters us from the harshness of the atomic wasteland and to whom we owe everything we have, including our lives. 1. The overseer. 2. The overseer. 3. The overseer. Or 4. The overseer. What will your answer be? 1, 2, 3, or 4? Like a moment to think about it. Okay, that's fine. You have your answer. Okay, what is it? position. And the last job is vault security guard. However, in order to obtain that one, you must be hand-picked by the overseer. So, we don't really know the criteria which the overseer uses to determine who could be vault security guard. However, it's quite possible that if you were to work as a vault loyalty inspector, seems that you might have a greater chance of being picked and becoming a vault security guard. So, out of all these occupations, which one do you think you have the most interest in? Okay, I will make a note. Second or third choice, just in case. Okay. And your third choice. Okay. Meeting you. Take care of yourself.